Hi, welcome to another edition of Play Branson. My name is Chris Meyer, and I'm here with Haley Westrich. Haley, it's good to see you.
Thanks, you as well.
So we got another great episode here today. And, you know, right now in Branson, we are kind of in the thick of spring break. And so there's, once again, lots going on and things coming up.
There's a ton. Well, Silver Dollar City is opening this weekend, and then starting on April 6th, they're going to have their new Festival of Wonder, which is all new this year, so it's going to be super exciting, so be sure to check that out.
So I've seen some of the billboards on Festival of Wonder, and looks like they're going to be bringing in some new talent and very unique things, so you'll want to be sure to go out there starting April 6th for this new Festival of Wonder. And, you know, anytime Silver Dollar City does a festival, they do it right.
Absolutely.
So that's exciting coming up. Now, part of what we do on this show is we give visitors new tips on how to make your vacation better. And so today I have got a couple things I want to talk about. And when you come on vacation, you are going to have to eat. And so we've got some great tools here that will help people on their vacation. So the first one here you see on is the Flavor of Branson Dining Guide. This is the most comprehensive book in town. It lists every restaurant. So if you want to know, you know, all the different types of restaurants, this is it. And the good thing about this is in the back of the book, as you go in the back, there's a really about 50 coupons, so it will help your dollars go farther in Branson. So this is located in over 200 locations, so as you go to your hotel, ask them about this, and you can check that out. There's another one I've got here. This is a newer publication in Branson. This is called The Dish. And this publication is really more about menus. And so, you know, if you want to see some of the menus before you get to the restaurant, this will be a good piece as well to check out. I love that picture, by the way.
It looks too
really good. And then last but not least, here's another one. There's lots of Branson maps out there, but this map is a restaurant-focused map. And you can see some restaurants. And then on the back, once again, here's some nice coupons. So there's several different ways there that you can get Branson restaurant information. Also, you can go to BransonRestaurants.com, and the restaurants are all listed there. And so, folks, that is our vacationer tip of the day. And in just a moment, we've got a guest.
We've got a guest from one of the largest performing families here in Branson. So stay with us as we welcome our guest coming up.
The Best Western Music Capital Inn. It's Branson's ultimate hotel, located across from the famous Shoji Tabuchi Theater. Relax in the indoor pool and hot tub. Enjoy the free hot breakfast every day. Gather in the lobby to reconnect with friends and family. For more information or to make reservations, call 877-334-8378.
Welcome back to Play Branson, and I am here today with Jason Hughes of the Hughes Brothers. Jason, It's great to have you here today.
It's good to be here.
So we were kind of wondering if you were going to make it, and you did.
Yeah,
and so I know you guys are so busy over there, and so we are so glad that you are here. And you know, you're the producer of this amazing show here in Branson, but it didn't just start here in Branson. And so tell people a little bit about your history and kind of how you got to Branson.
Sure. Well, we come into Branson, we were, well, start out, of course, with the five brothers. And when we were younger, both my parents were quite musical, and they loved to sing and play instruments. And so people in our neighborhood and at church knew that we liked to sing together. And so they would ask us to do things all of the time. And that's just how it started. And pretty soon they were offering us money. And
I bet people, you took it too,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we did. Well, Mom started us with singing lessons and piano and dance and different things like that. And of course, we always spent more money on those things than we ever made doing performances back then. But it was, you know, can you come over and sing for the ladies' luncheon dinner thing or something? Or, hey, we're having a business party for our Christmas party. Could you guys come over? We'll pay you $100. And of course, Mom would always treat that like it was the next biggest opportunity that ever existed. And so we would prepare for months. Of course, this is when we were quite little, and then go do a show, and that's just kind of how it started. And then I remember when I was about 12, 13 years old, we toured. We grew up in Utah in the Salt Lake Valley, and there are probably 40 different junior high schools. And we did the junior high school circuit.
Oh my.
So we went to did assemblies in all the junior high schools, and man, we were pretty hot stuff in the junior high school circuit.
And so you had the young girls screaming after you and stuff like that. You know,
after the show the girls would rush the stage and they'd grab Andy, our youngest brother, and carry him off. And sometimes they weren't trying to be rough, but he didn't like it. He'd hit his head on the lockers and different things. And so it took him maybe two or three performances to realize, you know, when the show's over, run and hide. So that's what he'd do. He'd just beeline it backstage and hide in the dark somewhere so they couldn't get him. The rest of us were too big to carry off, so yeah.
So from there, like, what happened next? Like, you didn't come to Branson right then.
No. All of my brothers, we all had an opportunity to do some missionary work, and some of us overseas at different times. And when we were kind of doing that, it slowed the Hughes brothers down a bit with the stuff that we were doing. And so we started to do some more individual things. And so Marty had a band. He was recording with his band and writing songs and doing different things like that. He was a music media major, so he was all in the songwriting and recording studio kind of stuff. And then I was a music dance theater major, and so I was very involved in musical theater, playing the leads in a lot of different musicals and different things like that. And as well as my other brothers were all very involved in musical theater and different things like that. And then once enough of us were home from the missionary work thing, then we were then again concentrated on what the brothers were doing, because that's really what we really wanted to do. And so there was a competition for an opportunity to record in Nashville. And so we went down and to Las Vegas and performed in this contest.
This was before American Idol days.
This was before American Idol.
Right?
Yeah, I don't even remember what the contest was called. Yeah, I don't. But I was like, do I? No, I don't. But we went down there. We won first place, which was, it was a recording contract to go to Nashville and record in Nashville. So we did that. We went to Nashville, recorded, and but in the meantime, Branson started the boom. This was probably 94.
Right.
And we decided, we were hearing, people were telling us all the time, you guys would be perfect in Branson. We're like, what's Branson? We don't know what Branson is. But we learned a lot about them because, of course, the Osmonds came here, and they got a lot of press in Utah, naturally. And so we started to hear more and more about Branson, and since we were already going to Nashville to record, we thought, well, if we're going to go all the way out to Nashville, we might as well stop by Branson and see
what it's all about.
Yeah. And so that was kind of a natural progression, and we were working with a vocal coach at the time that is an incredible vocal coach, actually. We wish he was here, but he's still back in Utah. But he had a connection with somebody with the March of Dimes. What do they call that? The telethon that they do.
Yeah, the Jerry Lewis.
The Jerry Lewis telethon.
Jerry Lewis telethon. Yeah.
And Silver Dollar City is very involved with that every year, and so he had a connection with the guy that was kind of a higher up and with all of that, and we did a promo video around that time, and he sent it to kind of get a feedback to see what we could do to improve our video. And when he saw our video, he said, you guys should be in Branson.
So all these people are telling you, you should be in Branson, you should be in Branson.
We would love to go to Branson and see what it's all about, but we don't know anybody in Branson. We don't have any connection. We don't know the first step. And he said, but I do. I know people at Silver Dollar City. So he sent our videotape that we'd made to Silver Dollar City, and D.A. Calloway, who's worked out there for years and hired entertainment out there, he viewed the videotape and hired us to come for a week to audition. So it was a paid audition. It was pretty cool. And then they, from that audition, they hired us for the next summer. And that's when we, that was 95, the very first year that we came. And so we basically, that's basically how it all happened.
And you know that we just recently interviewed Tim Haygood, and that was kind of how they got to Branson too, is through Silver Dollar City. So people, Silver Dollar City has actually played a pretty big role in bringing new entertainment to Branson.
Oh, very true. Very true. In fact, when we first came out there, the Haygoods were there with us. And so that was pretty exciting. They'd already, I think they had already been there maybe a couple years, but they were just little, and we were a little older than they were. And they were kind of standing and playing their fiddles and stuff. And we were coming in kind of with a more produced show with a lot of dancing and stuff. But we were only there for that summer.
And so then did you just transition then over to the highway, the strip?
Well, the Osmonds saw us out there, and they hired us to open for their show for a little while. And then a theater owner saw us in the Osmonds show and asked us if we would do our own show. That was the old Wild West Theater.
Wild West Theater
doesn't exist anymore. But we did. We were in the Wild West show for the following year, and we also did our morning show that year. So we were doing three shows a day, 6 days a week for the whole year.
So you put your time intense. In. You put your time in.
Oh, yeah. And and then after that, then another theater owner saw us and wanted us to go up onto the strip, and from that used to be the old Christie Lane Theater, which is gone now. Also, it's a bad sign. Once we leave, then theaters get torn down after that. But so that was kind of the progress of that, and we were there at the same time. Legends were there in that theater for about 3 years. And then the owner of the theater that we own now, Jim Thomas, who was actually responsible for bringing in a lot of the big stars initially.
Right.
And in fact, the theater that we own now used to be the Roy Clark Celebrity Theater, and that was kind of the first theater that brought in all of the big names.
Right.
And so that was. We had a lease option to buy the theater for 5 years and exercised our option at the end of five, and been there for now in that theater. This is our 17th year
in that theater. So as they say, the rest is history.
Yes,
right?
That's right.
Right.
The rest is history. Speaking of your show, it's one of the largest performing families.
Yeah.
So tell us how many people are in the show and each of the different roles that you guys have.
Yeah, well, when we first came to Branson, we didn't think that that's how it was going to turn out.
Right.
But it's just the five brothers, and Marty and I, the two oldest brothers, were married at the time, but we didn't think that we were going to be having, first of all, we didn't know we were going to have so many kids, but we didn't know that they were going to be in the show. We didn't necessarily expect our wives to be in the show either. But when we were down at the Wild West Theater, that first year, they asked us to do a Christmas show. We had 2 weeks notice to produce this whole 2-hour show with all new stuff in it. And at that time we decided, maybe our little 45-minute show that we did out at Silver Dollar City, it would be nice to have some girls in the show. So we had the girls join us, and then Marty's little daughter, oldest daughter at the time, was only 2. And she could sing and speak, and she was awesome. And so that she wandered up on the stage and did that. And from that, we started adding kids and wives, and now it's the five brothers, the five wives, and we have 39 children in the show now, ranging in age from the oldest is 23, and the youngest right now is 7 months, I think, and another one, we're expecting another.
Aww.
And also my oldest son, Aaron, just got married, so now we have one in-law in the
oh
show.
My gosh.
She's super talented also. So that'll start a whole other, you know, we could, in the next 20 years, we could easily double. There's no way we could have that many people on the stage. Already we're like, if we get everybody on the stage, which we do, but it could be pretty crowded.
Yeah, and I went to the Christmas show, and the whole family's out there in costume, and it's just amazing. So I want to stop here because we do need to take a quick break, and we'll be right back to continue this conversation in just a moment.
See it. Hear it.
The ultimate entertainment experience.
Can you feel it?
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 This is it.
Welcome back. We are talking today to Jason Hughes with The It Show featuring the Hughes Brothers. And so hopefully you enjoyed that video you just saw. And so, Jason, it's good to have you once again back for the second portion of our show.
Yeah, it's good to be here for sure.
Well, Jason, we were just talking about, you know, your family and everybody that plays a role in your show. And tell us a little bit about, like, the new additions that you have in this show and who all is doing what this year.
Oh, yeah. Well, the kids have always been very involved in the show, but this year we've changed things up a good amount. And there's a new medley that the teens are doing. It's super dynamic. It's got the song from Hey Geronimo, and there are a few other tunes in there. It's just, they're all over the place. It's just super exciting. And then also they're doing a new song on the show, violin tune, where we have, let's see, I think there's 9 violinists out on the stage.
Wow.
And then we bring out the big barrel drums, big barrels, and they play the drums. It's kind of like a Blue Man Group sort of thing, only Bransonized. but they play the theme song to the Halo, the video game. It's you just have to see it. It's super cool.
I'll be excited to see it for sure.
It's not very often. I mean, we produce things where I don't get very excited very easily, but if I sit back and I think, yeah, that's pretty cool. But when I watch that, I'm like, whoa, that is like majorly awesome. So that's great. And we've had a lot of other new tunes to the show, so it's a lot of fun.
So how do you decide what goes into the show? Do you get to make that decision? Is it a brother vote? Is it the whole family vote? How does this all happen?
Well, it's always a challenge to decide what the hardest thing is, decide what to take out when we when we add something, because, you know, so much of what we're doing we really like a lot. But it is, different people give their ideas, but ultimately I do decide.
So you have the power.
I do.
You have the power.
I have the power to decide. Well, I'm the one that has to decide where the songs are going to go, how they're going to fit, how much of what song, who's going to sing what, kind of try to make sense of it all and then stage it all and try to make sure that it flows right but also has a lot of variety in the show. And that's one thing that we've tried to accomplish, is having a large variety of different types of music in the show, but also presenting it in a lot of different ways. So we have the 5 brothers that are singing in really tight, beautiful harmonies, and our choreography, the things we do, is very different than from what the kids do. That's like super energetic and out there, and then solos and dance numbers. We even have in the show that one of my brothers sings the Phantom of the Opera, while his wife does ballet. She dances point. And anyway, it's just really cool variety of stuff.
And so at the end of the day, it's definitely a family-friendly show that everybody in the whole family can come and see. And they're not going to see a family this really large anywhere in the world.
No, we're the largest performing family in the world. And there's... Our show is, I mean, we don't put anything in the show that isn't absolutely awesome, that isn't as professional as it possibly can be. But I think that that's part of the magic of what we do, is just when people sit back and realize, whoa, this is one family that's doing all of this,
yeah.
Then it really hits you. And then it kind of brings it home too, because you kind of get all those warm, fuzzy feelings that you get when you're at a family reunion with your own family.
Yeah. You know, and I've been thinking about this, and I said, you know, for Branson, you know, there's a lot of junk going on out in the world, and Branson is a place where you can come and let your cares all go away and just have a good time, have a lot of fun. And that's what they're going to do when they come to your show, is just have a lot of fun and really be amazed at the end of the day. You guys are a very talented family. The other thing I want to talk about real quick, we're about out of time, but is you're doing these special kind of shows. Talk a little bit about these like special shows that you're doing.
Stop just for a second and let me get a drink. Suddenly I've just major itch, and I'm thinking it'd be better to. I've got water here already. For some reason, I think it's the cedar trees are starting to bloom, and they're just kind of.
Okay, do I need to?
No.
He just.
You just asked that question, then I can. About okay. The other shows that we have. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, we're really excited. This is the thing that we've been doing for the last couple of years, is different holidays we do a special show, or have special offers, different things that we do for those shows. For instance, we just did Valentine's Day, and a fun thing that we do for that is we have the whole audience renew their vows together.
Oh my gosh!
And today we just that was just a little bit ago, but. We distributed ring pops to everybody, so everybody could, you know, give a ring pop to their spouse. And the vows are kind of silly, but it's fun.
Right.
And then coming up, we have, St. Patrick's Day is coming up, and normally we give a large amount of money away for St. Patrick's Day, which is kind of
is that at the end of the rainbow kind of
yeah,
thing?
Yeah, end of the rainbow kind of thing, a yeah. Pot of gold. And then also we'll sing Irish tunes. You know, brothers have a great rendition of O Danny Boy. And then we also do, my favorite holiday show during the year is April Fool's. And April Fool's is just, I mean, every other number is we're playing practical jokes on each other.
So it's kind of crazy.
Well, last year I sewed my brother Adam's sleeve shut to one of his jackets. You know, he's out there trying to, and you know, there's this number where we, well, actually that's out of the show now, but where we follow each other kind of in a line, in a circle. We go upstage and then back downstage, and Andy's at the front of the line, so he's coming, and he goes downstage, and we just all danced off stage and left him on there by himself to finish the song. Yeah. Anyway, you know, just lots of fun.
So and unfortunately, we're going to have you back because we're out of time, yeah. But I got to make a quick plug, is you have an awesome Christmas show.
Oh, yeah.
And you've gotten lots of awards for that Christmas show, and so... and I did see it this year, and it was amazing.
Oh, thank you.
And so we'll have to have you back, or one of the other brothers back, to talk more about the Christmas show.
I think it's 10 years in a row that we've been voted the best Christmas show.
Yeah, so congratulations. Folks, we've run out of time today on Play Branson, and we're so glad that you spent a few moments with us, and we're so glad that Jason Hughes was here. When you're in Branson, be sure to go see It, featuring the Hughes brothers. Or if you're here at Christmas time, see the Hughes brothers Christmas show. And folks, you want to see the world's largest performing family. It's an amazing thing to see. They're incredibly talented. And guess what? You can get your tickets at ibranson.com. That's ibranson.com, or you can call them at 1-877-ENTERTAIN. Until the next episode, have a great day.